much to it for Ron and Cindy Powers.
All right, our flower girl and Link Bear with their parents. Let's hear it for Scarlett Miles with Marcy and Chris. All right, we're getting to the bridesmaids and groomsmen next. Let's hear it from Mandy and Ryan. Mandy and Ryan. All right, up next, Amanda and Tommy. Let's hear it, Amanda and Tommy. Up next, Ashley and Ryan. Let's hear it, Ashley and Ryan. Little teamwork there. All right, let's hear it. Up next is Rachel and Jeffrey. Rachel and Jeffrey. All right, up next, Kelly and Stefan. All right, up next, Danny and Bob. Let's hear it from Danny and Bob. All right, up next, Sarah and Adam. Let's hear it, Sarah and Adam. All right, at this time, everyone stand up. Let's stand up. All right, let's hear it as loud as you can right now for the brand new Mr. and Mrs. Mike and Laura Powers. All right, there you have it. Let's hear it for Mike and Laura again. A whole bridal party. Doing a great job. You guys can all be seated and get comfortable, and we're going to have our first dance right away. So here we go.
Sleep to escape from the sun. We woke up to the sound. that you love me, 'cause you do me so well to see you shine. I'll swing for the fences, I run to the lines.
So we're going to do the father-daughter dance right now. Let's hear it for Laura and her dad heading out there.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. Not one of those who can easily
some have gone and some remain. places after the home. With lovers and friends, I still can recall. Some are dead and some are living. In my life, I love them all. But of all these friends and lovers, there is no one compares with you. And these memories lose their meaning when I think of love as something new. Though I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that were before, I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I love you more.
Together and we met freshman year, but I didn't know that she and I were going to be lifelong friends until a Halloween party. And every other girl at that Halloween party was wearing something very typical, sexy maid, sexy librarian, sexy Goldilocks, you know, you get the picture. But Laura decided to come as broccoli. As in the vegetable. So, one, that's hilarious. Two, that's weird. And three, I love broccoli. So, I knew that she and I were gonna be lifelong friends at that exact moment. Our last 12 years, we've had a lot of crazy adventures, from midnight trips to Panama City, to crazy tailgates at the palace. Josh. Maria, you were there. Thursday nights at Bullwinkle's, Sunday nights at Taco Bell, and the 50 Nugget Challenge. We actually did that. from Cleveland to Tallahassee to Chicago to Denver, the Sugar Hill Gang really wrote Jump On It just for you. Thank you so much for being my co-parent with George Washington. Thank you so much for being the best cat aunt to Alice ever. Thank you so much for being my friend, Mike. When you don't know what to order for dinner, go with Taco Bell. Extra lava sauce, please. When you're traveling the world, Laura's luggage will always be over the weight capacity. And when the journey gets a little rough, you'll know that Laura's still smiling and has a positive attitude no matter what. So, can everyone please, oh, my drink's over here. Can everyone please raise a glass and toast to July 14th, 2019, the day of Mr. and Mrs. Michael Powers.
All right, great job. Let's hear it for Sarah once more.
That was a gorgeous ceremony with that mountain backdrop and everything.
Hey,
old guy.
There's a bat over here, too. I don't know if you guys saw that. That was pretty wild. And there was a bear earlier, too. Anyway, this is awesome being up in the mountains. I do want to thank both Patty and Bob Michaels, and also Cindy and Ron Pound Rowers. Thank you so much for everything that you did and putting this on, making everything happen. I'm Bob. I'm one of the co-best men. Another Bob here, which is a great name. And I met Mike back in sophomore year of high school. And well, actually, we probably met before. We played football together and everything, so we knew each other. But I think the first time we ever hung out was him and Parkhill came up to my locker, which was outside the gym, and they invited me over to Parkhill's house. We probably went and played like Dr. Mario or something, which was a lot of fun. And we grew up really dumb. We were really dumb kids. We would roll around in Parkhill's 96 Cadillac DeVille, blasting rap and drinking Cavassier and smoking Swisher Sweets, which we thought was super cool. It's not. We would also laugh at our friends who turned green, sickly green. We'd just make fun of them. I loved the summer we spent at Camp Michael Jordan. That was great. Also nuggeting Dan McKinney's backpack every day of world history. That's amazing. For you, those of you who don't know what nuggeting is you take someone's backpack, you take everything out, and you turn it inside out. So all the straps and everything are inside the backpack. And then you put all their stuff back in. Hopefully they don't notice until the period bell rings. So then they have to walk through the halls with this giant nugget. Just great, great girl. But we were idiots. We were definitely idiots. All of us. But we got a lot smarter as we grew up. Powers went to U of I, got his arts degree in actual sciences. He's like the only person in his class to actually get an arts degree, which is kind of funny. He also got his realtor's license, bought a couple of properties, made some rental income, so good for him on that. He also got an engineering degree as well. He's probably the smartest person I know. And I hang out with a lot of smart people, except for Kanik. Who's the other co-best man. I work in tech and do startup life, and there's a lot of smart people, but Pardo's honestly the smartest person I've ever met. But the smartest thing he ever did was ask Laura out on a date. And, story was told from there. They're wonderful people. Laura's amazing. Mike, thanks for being a friend all these years. I know I'm not the easiest friend in the world. But I love you guys. Thank you so much for coming skiing with me and Breck a couple years ago, meeting me up there. There's two. Thanks for letting me stay over at your house during Thanksgiving. That was a lot of fun last year. You guys are very hospitable, and I know we live several states apart, but I hope we always continue to be so close. Thanks again. You guys are going to have an awesome trip. I love you both.
First off, I want to start off by saying, hey, on behalf of my wife, Patty, Ron and Cindy Powers, Mike and Laura, as my brother mentioned at the ceremony, we really appreciate everybody being here. We understand the travel logistics of getting here. It's hard to get to. It's on a Sunday. It costs a lot of money. We fully appreciate everybody being here. It really means a lot. And so our deepest sincere gratitude for all of you being here. So I met Mike about 5 years ago. Laura had been hyping him up, talking about him a lot. And she was kind of giving this indication of like, you know, I think this might be the one. And so we arranged to meet at a bar in Chicago. And I was thinking, yeah, you know what? I'll make the determination. And I got to say that, when he showed up, it was just like, wow. And, you know, he's a good-looking, smart guy. He loves music. He loves the outdoors. He's very nice to Laura. It was just like, wow. He has a great sense of humor. It's like, I think this is a guy. And Patty and I left the bar that night thinking, someday, hopefully, we'll like, here. Doing this. And, darn. God, I'm so close. But I just want to say, I got it. We are so happy for you guys. They have so much in common. They just love the outdoors. They love to laugh. it's just so great to see them. It's just like, we're so excited, so happy for this. We're so excited for Laura to be a part of the Powers family, who we've gotten to know over the last year or two. They're just awesome. And boy, it's just great. We love the day. Thank you so much, everybody, for being here. And cheers to Laura and to Mike.
Hey, everybody. I'm Canik, and I've got something to say. Hit it.
Mike. Mike Powers. Mike Powers. He's one hell of a guy. He can punch through mountains and he looks pretty fly. Mike Powers, my friend and partner in crime. Underage drinking? No, not one time. Mike Powers. He's a skee-ball MVP. Bowled a 299 with one leg broken on the Wii. Mike Powers. He is the man. And that's what I'm about to make you understand. I've known Yao Ming since back in the day. Risk life that might be fun is what we used to say. Motivating each other to do the insane. Somehow we both survived. Crack open the champagne. Trampoline flips and skateboard tricks. Link's computer had some nasty pics. In Roman Candle Wars, all is fair. We went trick-or-treating in our underwear. We call him Beer Man, and our crimes well rehearsed. Stealing beer out garages just to quench our thirst. Smash Brothers, we would play for hours. We learned who has a dicky do from Pond Rowers. Then we started to urban climb. Scaling buildings like Spider-Man had lost his mind. Jumping from roof to roof across city blocks. We freeze like gargoyles when we see the cops. We've all heard it before, it's amazing we're still alive. But this is the stage at which your life begins to thrive. He found his soul and she's a checkmate. Firework explosion since the first date. A bunch of peas in a pod. Welcome to the squad. She is the bomb, dude, I'm giving you the nod. Now he's married Laura and she is the best. So raise your drinks to the sky and enjoy the fest.
The Power Juice.
To the bride and groom, love you guys.
Clip because my tie wasn't.
It wasn't good enough.
It wasn't long enough.
Oh man! I think
actually, that was a good accent. Right?
We made it.
We made it.
We did it. Yeah, we made it.
Hi, Ann. Stop right there.
Oh, I'm done.
me. Hi, Daddy.
That's cool. Thank you.